Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm walking you through how to create your brands in Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and get started. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express, and what you'll see on the left-hand side, the menu option is brands. And here's where you will store all of your brands. You can add your logos, your colors and fonts, and other images that you might use continually as part of your brand. Now, I'm actually going to start from scratch. I have several accounts now. I have a premium account and I also have some education accounts as well. So I'll show you a little bit of differences. So this is my personal one. And here I am in my education account. You can see it says Adobe Express for Education, and here's brands. And here's another personal account that I have with no brands, and I will create brands here. The steps that I take will work across the education version as well as your personal accounts. So let's go ahead and start by creating a new brand here. And we're going to name this. I'm going to call this Zarte, Z Art, Zavala Art. And we'll click on create brand. And here you'll see the process. We'll start the overview over here on the left. You can add logos, colors, fonts, templates, and assets here. Let's go ahead and start with logos. I do have some logos created for this brand, so we'll go ahead and upload those logos. I'll go ahead and continue by clicking on add over here and choose logo, and I'll just upload all the different logos that I have for this brand. Okay, so now I've got all my logos added for my brand. So the next step is actually going to add colors for my brand. So I'll click over here on colors, and here's where I can choose to add colors. So I'm going to show you a way you can do this with your accounts. And what we're going to do is head on over to color.adobe.com, and that's where we will grab our colors. So here is Adobe Color. If you've never seen this website, it's great for colors, finding accessible themes, extracting themes and gradients from images that you have. But I actually am going to create color themes. I already have my brand color, so I'll click on visit here. As you can see, you can set up colors and different color harmonies, monochromatic, triads, and so on. So you can decide whichever way you want to. Now, what I will do is first off, start off here in the center, and it says change color. And I have my hex numbers for my color, so I'm going to go ahead and enter it here. And that is the brand color that is part of my logo. I'll go ahead and show you again. Here's my logo, and there it is right there. So what I want to do is create a palette of colors to use in my brand. So basically creating this from scratch using Adobe Color here. So here's my main color. And as you can see, there's it's set up to triad. Let me try analogous, and let's go monochromatic. And let's see, complementary. So you can go through and see which palettes of colors you like for your brand. And so what I'm going to do is probably go to monochromatic so I can stay in kind of a theme here, maybe analogous. That's kind of cool. It's got this other color. So you're using kind of this tool to help you find those colors that kind of go well together. So I think I'm going to go ahead and stick with the monochromatic for now. So I've got these colors for my brand. Maybe I'll go a little wild. Let's go triads here. Let's go with that one here. All right. And what I will do over here on the right-hand side is I've got my account here already set up. I created a folder, but what you can do here is click here and create a new library, which I've already done here, which is Zarte. And I'm gonna call this brand colors. And what I will do here is I'm going to uncheck this publish theme. I do not want this to be public, it's just myself. And these are the colors that I'm going to be using for my brand. And I'll click on save. Now, if you already have your colors, then you don't have to go through this process, but you can change the hex numbers down here to fine tune it to get it to match your colors. You can kind of go with different variations in hues of your brand colors. I'm going to go ahead and click on save over here. And now this is saved in my account. So this is my personal account. And so now what I'm going to do is go back to Adobe Express, and I'll go back to colors here. And you'll see right here, it says add colors. Now what I need to do is just wait a little bit for the syncing process to take place because it's saving to the cloud. And then I will see my brand colors here that I found over here in Adobe Color. So let's go ahead and give it a little bit of time and we'll see it pop up right here. And there are my colors that I have found over on Adobe Color website. So this is now part of my brand colors. Also, you can add additional color palettes and swatches if you want, just by clicking on color swatch, and this will show up. Once you select and save it, you'll see color swatches here. So if you have other colors you want to add to choose from, you can do that here. You could also add other color palettes by doing it here, or you can do it in the color Adobe Color website. All right, now let's go on over to fonts, and we want to add fonts. And what you'll do is click on add fonts here, and you'll see all the fonts that are available with your Adobe Express account. As you can see, you scroll through. And so many of us will have common fonts that we can choose from, because these are all made available within Adobe Express. And you'll see these ones with the little crown. These are the premium access fonts. So you need to be aware of that when you are creating content and also sharing brands, and we'll talk a little bit about that shortly. So again, the crown icons represent the premium features, which I do have access, and then you'll see ones without crowns, which pretty much are available in the freemium version of Adobe Express as well as in the premium. So just be aware of that. So you can go through here, you can go to more fonts and find fonts that you like. And so the font that I used in my logo happens to be Westgate. So I'm gonna type in Westgate, and there it is. And so what I'm going to do is add pretty much all of the fonts from Westgate into my brand. I'm going to go ahead and go through the process here. Let's type in Westgate one more time. And as you can see, we have bold, semi-bold, regular. So I want to add all those to my brand. And then we'll go to the next step. I finished adding the Westgate font that I'll use for my brand. This is the font that's actually in my logo, but I want to add additional fonts that I may use in my project. So what I will do is click on add and go to font. And again, pretty much the same window, more fonts, but we have this upload option. So you can upload fonts if you have your own fonts. Now, one thing to be aware, you should have license for those fonts, or either purchase them or maybe make your own fonts. So we'll click on upload, and you'll see an option here. You can add fonts to the cloud in your Adobe application, so you can use these across multiple applications. So it's just a matter of dropping the fonts here. So let's go ahead and add my font here. I'm going to drop it here. So you can see it's Eleanor regular. And you'll notice here, by uploading the font, you acknowledge that you have all the necessary rights. I've actually purchased this font, so I do own it. And so I'm going to go ahead and click add. So just be aware of that when you are uploading fonts. If you're finding free fonts that are, you know, royalty free, just be aware you may or may not be able to. Best practice is to purchase a font. And so here it is, a body style for Eleanor. So that's my additional font. So I've added my fonts, I've got my logos and colors here. And next up, you'll see our templates. And here's where you can create templates that you can use. Say, for example, you post every Wednesday a positive message and you have like a designed template. You can do that here and basically use that as your starting point, as your template every Wednesday when you share on social. I'm not going to do that here now. I'll do that later. And next up, you'll see our assets. And here I do want to upload some images that I may use often in my projects, maybe a headshot. So let's go ahead and upload here one of my headshots. I went ahead and added several photos here that I'll use. So again, this is part of my brand. And so now I've got it pretty much set up. Let's click on overview, and here are all the assets and logos and colors and fonts for my brand. So let's go ahead and click on the home button here, and let's find a project here that we can use to demonstrate the use of your brand. So let's scroll through here and find something where we can swap out a picture here. Let's try this one right here just for fun. Got this big sale here. Let's go ahead and click that, and we'll start by clicking on the picture here, and we'll come up here to replace, and you'll see we have these options. Let's go to brands, and got this here, and we'll go ahead and click on my picture right here. There it is, now it's swapped out. And now I can go ahead here and do remove background. Perfect. And now what we can do is we can come up here to theme, and the theme's basically all your palettes, but there is my color theme, Zarte. And if I click here, see how it changes everything into my brand colors. So I scroll through here. It's a very cool hack here. And if you want to, after this, you can go through and click the boxes or any type of the assets here and basically change out the colors based on your theme. So you have your theme available right here, so you can change those out. And then again, an easy swap. Now I see my font right here. We have my brand right here, big sale. And then let's go over here, and this is going to be my other brand. Let's do Westgate. See, I have all my content available. And then let's say, for example, right here, I want to add my logo. So we'll come over here to brands, and you'll see I've got my logo, view all, and we're gonna add my brand right there. Look at that, beautiful. Make it available just by finding it, so I don't have to go searching on my computer for any of my brand materials like logos, fonts, and images. And this will be available across all platforms. So if I log in on my phone, I can access my brands as well. So one more thing before we wrap up here. So let's head on over back to the home button here, and let's go back to brands. And one other thing that you can do with your brands is click on the three little dots up here, and you can share your brands with others to use. And one thing to be aware is that when you are doing this, you may or may not be able to share out of your account, depending on the type of account. So if you're in education, you may not be able to share outside because you may be prevented depending on the settings your school district has. Personal accounts, you pretty much have free reign because it's your personal account. I would also remember about the premium version. So if you share it with someone that may not have premium access, they may not be able to see or use the assets. So just be aware of that. Here you see can view and use. If you give them access to edit, then they can change your brand. So you don't want that. You just want to allow they can view and use. So let's go ahead and invite to view and use. So I've invited myself, my other account. So let's go ahead and take a look on the other account. So here I am on my other account here. This is where I have my I Am Claudius brand. And up here in the top right corner, notification, I've been invited to this brand. I'm going to accept. And let's give it a little bit of time here. We may need to do a little refresh. And there is the Zarte brand. So let's go ahead and click on home here. And if I go and open up a project, let's just do a random one. Let's go with this one right here. And let's go with theme. And I'll have multiple brands here. This is my personal brand. You know, to swap it out. And then if I decide to go with, let's try Zarte brand. There we go. So I have access to the brand here as well as the fonts. If I click right here, you'll see Zarte. And if I click here, I can swap out and go back to my brand right here. So very cool feature, the ability to share across accounts. And just be aware again of the premium assets, the ones with the crowns when you're doing the share. And that's how to create your own brands in Adobe Express. And that's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for future videos just like this one. And please, please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, have fun creating. Peace.